How do I get files from a machine that won't boot? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. I have to shut down and open my machine several times until it works. It just hangs after the Windows logo and you feel you can work with it, but nothing's there. You can move the mouse, but there's no connection. It's a completely frozen PC. Today, it does not want to start or work at all. I have files that I want to save before I can format it. How do I get them if the machine won't boot? Okay, my snarky response is you get them from your most recent backup. However, if you're asking this question, it's because you don't have the most recent backup. So before we even get into answering the question, I want to use this as an opportunity to remind you that if you were backing up your machine, you wouldn't have a problem. This simply wouldn't be an issue for you because you'd be able to get what you need from your backup. The fact that it was starting to have problems was probably a sign that you should even start taking a backup right then before things get worse. We are where we are. Let's see what we can do. My number one solution in a situation like this, honestly, is to remove the drive from the machine and insert it into an external USB enclosure. What that allows me to do then is take that drive and connect it to any other PC or any other device, honestly. You can connect it to your Mac if you like. But the point is that if the problem is not a readability issue with the drive itself, then you can access everything that's on it. On that other PC, you can copy off what you need. You can do whatever it is you need to do to get the information off that hard drive. That solution, while it does require opening up the machine and taking the drive out, is probably the easiest conceptually, because once you've got it in an enclosure, and to be clear, there are cables you could use that actually don't include an enclosure. You just connect it up to the external hard drive and connect the other end as a USB connection. But the bottom line is that once you've got it connected up to another working PC, you're just copying files. You're just doing what you do with Windows or the other operating system you're already familiar with. Now, the other solution that I believe is also useful, but slightly more complex in an odd kind of way. I'm not going to step through it, but the companion article for this video, askleo.com/5011, will show you some steps. The bottom line for this solution is that you create yourself a bootable Linux USB. It needs to be what they call a live USB, or formerly a live CD. The intent is that you would then boot this machine, assuming that it's not a hardware problem preventing you from booting anything, but you would boot this machine from this USB image of Linux, and in that USB image of Linux running on that machine, you would then be able to see the contents of the internal hard drive and then copy things potentially from that hard drive to another flash drive that you've created or another external drive that you use so that you can once again extract the contents of the files from that machine. I'm not going to walk through it. And the reason I point to the article is that in depending on the Linux and the configuration of your hard drive and the configuration of your machine, there may be some steps involved to get Linux to notice or be able to read the files off of your hard drive, but it's not terribly difficult. It is kind of sort of step by step. It involves the Linux equivalents of permissions and their partition manager and their and drive tools and so forth. And that's fine. It's not that difficult. It is more complex and it does require a little bit of comfort in Linux, but it's another tool that could potentially get the job done. Now, there's one scenario that I really, really, really want to cover and emphasize, again, in context with you should be backing up that drive. If the drive has encryption on it, as more and more drives do these days, my encryption, I mean BitLocker or any kind of whole drive encryption, then the techniques that I've mentioned above, they're not going to work because the drive's encrypted. The whole point of encrypting the drive is to prevent exactly the kind of extraction we're looking to perform. That's why backing up, especially lately, is so incredibly important. Take full image backups of that drive regularly so that no matter what happens to the drive, when, not if, it fails. You still have the opportunity to get all of your data back from that most recent backup. I hope that helps. For comments, for updates, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/5011. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.